During my graduate studies, I got fascinated by the fundamental question of how the brain works and how it actually develops and functions. So I initially used the model systems to study ventral midbrain in mouse embryos. And understanding ventral midbrain on molecular level is important to develop new cell therapies for Parkinson's disease. So while animal models are powerful and excellent scientific foundation, I got interested in translational research and essentially how to make a more immediate impact on human health. And I was fortunate to meet my current supervisor, Dr. Ilya Singac, at an international neuroscience symposium back in 2017. At around that time, he was building this new stem cell translation laboratory here at NCATS. And it has been really amazing experience to join this new group, learn many new skills, grow as a scientist, and also become a part of the NCATS family. So I'm a senior postdoctoral fellow here in the stem cell translation laboratory at NCATS, where I work on advancing the human induced pluripotent stem cells into clinical applications. Induced pluripotent stem cells, or iPSCs, can be generated from any person by reprogramming their skin or blood cells. Later, they can serve as inexhaustible source for many specialized cell types in the human body, such as brain cells, liver cells, or heart cells. In one of my projects, I developed a new method to turn efficiently and reproducibly iPSCs into astrocytes, which are important cell type in the brain. Astrocytes are key to normal brain function, but are also implicated in various brain diseases, such as autism, epilepsy, or Alzheimer's, and many others. And until now, it has been really challenging to obtain large numbers of human astrocytes for biomedical research and cell therapies, altogether representing an unmet medical need. By developing this new strategy, I was able to produce astrocytes efficiently and in a faster way as compared to previously published approaches. So for instance, if other approaches take several months, our new method derives astrocytes in about a month. Now we can essentially utilize the robustness of this approach and produce human astrocytes at industrial scale here at NCATS using the robotic cell culture platforms that we have. Then enabling high throughput projects for disease modeling, drug discovery, and regenerative medicine applications. Receiving translational training, translational research training here at NCATS, and taking advantage of the unique opportunities available here, it's actually a privilege for any early career scientist like myself. I was given an opportunity to use cutting-edge technologies while working on important projects that will have a long-lasting impact on translation of iPSC technology into clinical applications. So this exposure to a broad set of methods and technologies used here at NCATS has definitely provided a great impact on my future career and prepared me in the best way possible for the future opportunities.